community, plagued by social injustices and hardships, hope shines through the faces of our Menstrual Hygiene Initiative beneficiaries. Recently, Isisa's media team visited Elang'ata Wuas Primary School in Kajiado, Kenya, where the struggles faced by the students are unimaginable. Imagine these young minds walking over 15 kilometers to reach school, not only burdened with their school supplies, but also carrying jerrycans filled with water for their only chance at a meal during the day.
My name is Esther Njage. I'm a teacher in this school, Elang'ata Wuas Primary School. Actually, let me say we are very happy having you here. Feel most welcome. And now to start with, when we talk of issue menstruation, to me, every girl who has matured, every female who has matured, at least they are supposed to be experiencing the menstrual cycle. At least every month they get their period. It's fun and it's enjoyable.
These boys also need this knowledge, especially because they have their sisters. One time they'll also grow to be fathers. So to me, this knowledge of menstrual is also required for boys, so that they grow when they know this and they know what is required in every situation. Okay, to add on it, there was a point you were asking me about boys. Let me say, boy child has been left for a long time. And maybe probably I can say it's because maybe most of the proposals that have been made earlier on, they were measuring on the problems a girl child was facing.
Kuna places unaweza kujipata mmekaa kama groups, mko na boys na girls, unaweza kuongelesha girls, unaweza kustart your conversation ya hiyo usafi, unawasaidia unapewa tu advice.
Unaingiza hivyo, so haitaingia ndani, unaona? So vile our body is designed.
I'm Cheryl Mboya. I'm an innovator, climate change champion, child rights and human rights advocate, and the managing director at Isisa Limited. Isisa Limited was formerly known as GreenX Telemechanics and was incorporated in 2020 as an innovation and technology developer. However, over the past 3 years, we've been able to notice that GreenX Telemechanics didn't quite embody what we had envisioned the company to be about. And basically, the company is all about providing innovative solutions towards challenges our community faces. So we are rebranding to Isisa Limited, and Isisa is a Shona name to mean gratitude to the community, where we are providing innovations from the community for the community.
So say yata, how feel like it was that comfortable?
In our case here, you find it's a bit challenging because of so many issues, cultural factors, poverty, all those things. But we have had girls even getting out of school, they drop out of school because of maybe they are not getting the necessary whatever pads and what they need during that period. And now you find maybe they just go out, look for other people to give them such things, and they might end up even to border riders and other people.
Okay, we are undergoing so many challenges because not all parents can be able to face their children and make sure that they know that they need sanitary towels every month, not all of them. And also we are facing some challenges like, right now I'm less than 2 years since I came to this school. I came in July 2021. And that was the last time that the government issued the sanitary towels for us.
Every step, every effort, every ounce of compassion poured into this initiative is a beacon of hope for these children.
I feel comfortable. I try to tell them to open up, tell us the issues that are disturbing them. But some of those things they, I told you earlier on, they keep on repeating them. Like, okay, we also have the retrogressive culture in this community, whereby now speaking of menstruation is regarded as an abomination to them. So, and you find even to the mothers, they might not be able to speak it up with the girls. But for us, when they come to school, at least we try to help them, we try to assist them. And also, maybe with your initiative, I hope you're going to create more awareness. Yes.
One of the initiatives undertaken by the foundation in cooperation with the company is a menstrual hygiene initiative that is dubbed period with an exclamation mark, because we want to be able to ensure that people actually normalize saying period without associating any shame or stigma to the function itself.
I'd like you to promote the project is that by mentoring our students, if possible, at least on timely basis, and also supply the school with the sanitary tiles.
So at the end of the day, we need to have a lot of information for them on how to take care of them in each and every situation.
In partnership with the county governments of Nyandarua, Kajiado, Machakos, and Nairobi, and our private sector partners, the Adulting Podcast, the Inwadada Foundation, the Kenya Red Cross, the LU University, and the Rera University, we appeal to you and plead that you join us in making this initiative a success and bring joy to the various faces of those who desperately need us in the society. Period dignity, one cup at a time.